head of the city BTO was in Israel. He met with us, and he concludes the meeting, and I think that he stated it publicly, that the question is not about if Israel is going to ratify the CTBT, but when. So this, I think this is a question that you should point to me, and I will try to answer it. But before answering this question, I would like to try to present the Israeli policy towards non-proliferation and this kind of nuclear issues, because Israel had a bad experience with trying to implement multilateral mechanisms that works in other places and trying to implement it in the Middle East. On the one hand, we see that they are not very efficient with the NPT. We saw, we are all aware that four different countries in the region ratified the NPT, were trying to develop military dimensions of their nuclear programs. One of them is in the core of the international debate right now. On the other hand, Israel fears or experience real misuse of these mechanisms, and a blatant example is the CTBT, because Israel is part of the MESA, Middle East and South Asia group. Now Iran, because of the Iranian veto to function this group, this group is dysfunctioning, because the Iranians do not agree to work in the same group with Israel. So this bad experience really made Israel think, and in Israel, I think this is basically about foreign policy. There is a real discussion in Israel. It's very open about the CTBT. So we know all the facts. We know that Israel sees this process in three steps. The first step is, of course, to sign the treaty, and Israel signed the treaty. And it reflects Israel's acceptance of the general principles and the objective of the CTBT. And Israelis were actively participating in the consolidating process of the CTBT. Israel worked very close with the CTBTO in improving these mechanisms and in regional consultations. So this is the first step. Now the second step, and I think this is a big difference, is not the ratifying, but trying to create regional mechanism, credible one. And to this regard, Israel established some monitoring system. Israel works very closely with the CTBTO. I'm sure that we can make this cooperation even better in the future. But I think that we reach a point where is very good cooperation between Israel and the CTBTO. Israel's data are going directly to the IDC. And Israel, it's really have good discussions with CTBTO's seniors. And now, we ask ourselves, why not ratifying? And now I would like to ask you to look into the region, because two main countries, one is Iran, the second one is Egypt, they haven't ratified the treaty yet. But forget about the ratifying. What about the monitoring systems? None of them really promoted or developed monitoring systems like Israel did in order to create some kind of regional confidence building measures, try to build trust between the countries and trying to make the regional system more effective. So what Israel should do now? I think Israel should try and even improve even more the relations with and cooperation with the CTBTO on a bilateral basis. And I hope that the countries around us will try to promote some kind of regional mechanism in order to establish a good basis for a real discussion about the ratifying process. Because ratifying, it's the first step. It's the last step, sorry, not the second one. And we don't want to put the horse put the cart before the horse. So now, I think we should focus on regional mechanisms. And I'm telling you that Israel looks to Washington, to Beijing, and their position, I don't think it's helpful it's not contributing for the credibility of this kind of mechanism. So I think now, if we want to really advance this issue in the Middle East, we need to find some way to adjust these very, very important principles and very, very important goals to the Middle East reality. And I'm sure that it can help, and it can be valuable in different aspects that exceeded the nuclear arena. But when, and I think you mentioned the Iranian nuclear program, when we talk about nuclear issues in the Middle East, I will ask you not to detach it from the regional atmosphere, from the conventional threats, because in the Middle East, it's all interrelated. You cannot talk about only about nuclear weapons and not talk about conventional threats. And if you have specific questions about it, I would be glad to answer you in the Q&A session. Thank you.